After the Hehe Rebellion finished, Germany finally had established control over Tanzania. Karl Peters was returned to a leadership position, and Germany East Africa defined its borders. The colony was very poor, though, and had little infrastructure and few services and wealth. So a labor law was enforced. Adult men of the tribes were taken from their villages and forced to do labor and work for the colonial government, basically slavery. All the men of age were taken out of their villages and forced to build roads or work in the cotton fields the Germans had set up in the tropical savanna. This changed the whole lives of the natives. With the men gone, the young or the women had to take over, do the farming, hunting, and tribal warfare. The Germans also forced each village to grow cotton instead of food on a bunch of their fields. If they didn't meet their monthly quota of cotton exportation, the Germans would come to their village and wreak havoc. The lack of men to farm and hunt, as well as being forced to grow cotton instead of food on a bunch of their fields, created a giant food shortage among the natives. Many died of starvation. Many tribes across southern Tanzania were brutally oppressed and wanted freedom as well. But the chiefs did not have much they could do. So they looked to their spiritual leaders instead. A spiritual leader from southeast Tanzania, named Kinjit Kitaile Ngwale, or simply Bokiro as he was known, believed he had an answer to these problems when he had a vision in 1905. He believed that the tribe should overlook their differences and unite together to drive the Germans out of the interior of Tanzania, and the tribes listened. In early July of 1905, the rebellion started. The rebels were armed with spears and bows, with few guns as well, but they were numerous, with an estimate of possibly 10,000 rebels from various tribes involved. They began attacking German outposts, caravans, and cotton plantations, liberating men from the plantations and recruiting them to their rebellion. In early August, during a raid, Bokiro was captured by the Germans and hung, making him a martyr. His brother took over and led the reinvigorated rebels. It all came to a head on the 14th, when the rebels killed the Bishop of German East Africa. The Germans sprung into action and tried to stop them at the village of Ifakara on the 16th of August, but the rebels beat them back. They now tried to take a main base in southern Tanzania, Mahenge. This was the most famous battle of the war. The heroic defense of Lieutenant Theodore von Hassel, a few Europeans, and a couple hundred untrained Africans who held the town successfully against several thousand rebel warriors until reinforcements showed up. With the help of two machine guns, they killed nearly 600 warriors while taking less than two dozen casualties themselves. Even though for the small victory at Mahenge, and another in early September, at this point, the whole southern part of Tanzania was in open rebellion. The German colonial garrisons were shattered and outnumbered 15-1, and the rest of the colony was threatened. By September, the south was firmly under Mahi-Mahi control, and the tribes were raiding places daily. This is when Governor Gustav Adolf von Gotzen requested German reinforcements. By November, over 1,000 German reinforcements had arrived, not only from Germany, but from its other colonies too, notably the New Guinea jungle troops, who were well adapted to the jungle of western Tanzania. The German troops, nearly 2,000 strong now, split into three columns and advanced on the south. The tribesmen used guerrilla warfare tactics and surprise attacks. The Germans, on the other hand, used large groups of men and split through the Mahi-Mahi lines. Any villages they came across, they killed most of the men of fighting age and burned or stole all the crops, which would have serious effects later. The main column under Major Kurt Johans started in Kilwa and made it to Songea by the end of the year. In spring of 1906, the main column marched on Mahenge, where a small German garrison still existed after the battle. They met up and cut off the rest of the Mahi-Mahi in the south. The columns then spread out into small groups of 40 to 100 men. Many tribes surrendered, but some still held out for another year in a brutal guerrilla war that that raged all across the south of the country. But rather than deliberately try to fight the rebels, the small groups of Germans concentrated on going to villages and burning food, and not supplying any of the tribes. Trying to starve out the rebels, basically. This resulted in a terrible famine that swept all through the country. By mid-1908, the last rebellious tribal chiefs were executed, and the last rebels surrendered. But the damage to the land had been done. Over the ensuing years, over 250,000 Africans would die of the resulting famine. Less than 9,000 men died of actual combat in the war, while a quarter of a million died of starvation and hunger following the rebellion. This is considered a genocide in modern history.